engine run-up checklist.
The engine run-up checklist is used to ensure the aircraft's flight controls are functioning properly and the appropriate navigation equipment and flight plans are loaded. Note, while conducting the engine run-up checklist, the pilot must reference their checklists to confirm all items have been checked before continuing. At first, pilots will rely on the checklist to guide their run-up, but with experience, pilots begin doing the required pre-flight checklist line items and then verifying by reviewing the checklist.
Before taking off, the pilot must ensure that the aircraft's controls and engine are functioning properly by conducting a run-up. First, the pilot checks that the flight controls are free and correct. This is done by moving the control wheel to the left and right, as well as back and forward, and stepping on the rudder pedals while looking at the control surfaces to ensure they are properly functioning. Then, the pilot sets the parking brake.
One way a pilot can ensure that the flight controls are moving in the right manner is using their thumbs. By grabbing the control wheel and putting their thumb up, a pilot can ensure the ailerons are moving correctly. When the pilot turns the control wheel left, their thumbs point left, which means the aileron on the left wing should be pointing upwards. Turning the control wheel to the right, the pilot's thumb points upwards to the right, indicating that the aileron on the right wing should not be pointing upwards. When moving the control wheel forward away from the pilot, they should see the elevator control surface move downward. When the control wheel is pulled back towards the pilot, they should see the elevator control surface move upward. Lastly, the pilot should step on each rudder pedal independently while looking at the vertical stabilizer and rudder control surface. The rudder should deflect the same direction as the rudder. Left rudder makes the rudder control surface turn left, while right rudder makes the rudder control surface turn right.
After confirming the flight controls are free and correct, the pilot then checks the PFD and MFD for any red X's. If any red X's are present, the pilot should request to taxi back to the ramp and have maintenance check the airplane. Next, the pilot checks that the standby instruments are still reading correctly. If the airplane's vacuum pump is not functioning properly, the backup attitude indicator will not read correctly. Then, the pilot tests the autopilot if the aircraft is equipped with an autopilot system by engaging it and ensuring that the autopilot can control the pitch and bank. The pilot also checks that the autopilot will disengage safely and that the electric trim, if the aircraft is equipped with an electric trim, is functioning. Now the pilot is ready to conduct the engine run-up. First, ensure the fuel selector is still on the both position and that the mixture is full rich. Then the pilot advances the throttle to 1800 RPMs. The pilot then checks the two magnetos to ensure they are functioning and grounded properly. The pilot turns the key to the left magneto first, which turns off the right magneto. The pilot should see a decrease in RPMs, no more than 150 RPMs. For example, if the engine was at 1800 RPMs before switching to the left magneto only, the RPMs should not drop below 1650 RPMs.
Then the pilot returns the key to the both magnetos position.
If the parameters are acceptable, the pilot then checks the right magneto by moving the key to the right magneto position, which isolates the right magneto. The pilot should see a decrease in RPMs, no more than 150. The difference in RPMs between the two magnetos should not exceed 50 RPMs. For instance, if the left magneto produced 1700 RPMs, the right magneto should be within 1650 to 1750 RPMs. If either magneto does not pass this test, the pilot can attempt to clean the spark plugs of carbon deposits by leaning the mixture and increasing the power for a minute to burn off any deposits on the spark plugs. After this is done, the magneto check should be conducted again. If there is no change in the RPMs when isolating one of the magnetos, this means that the P lead or ground wire has become disconnected, known as a hot magneto. The pilot should taxi back to the maintenance facility and have maintenance fix the issue.
If the ignition key is turned to the off position during this check, the pilot should allow the engine to turn off, then restart the engine and conduct the entire magneto check again.
Once the magnetos are checked, the pilot leaves the throttle at 1800 RPMs and checks that the engine indications and vacuum pump are within the green areas of their gauges. The ammeters are charging, and the voltmeters are between 27 and 29 volts, and that there are no annunciators present. Finally, the throttle is pulled all the way out for a few seconds to conduct an idle check. The aircraft should not stop running during the idle check. If it does, the pilot needs to bring the aircraft to the maintenance facility to have it checked out.
Before taxiing to the active runway, the pilot should input their flight plan on the MFD of the G1000 if they are flying a specific flight plan. The required navigation source should be activated by pushing the CDI soft key on the PFD of the G1000. The transponder should be set to the transponder code provided in the departure clearance, or 1200 on a VFR flight that's not on a flight plan. The pilot should brief the departure they will be conducting if applicable, and the parking brake released. Now the pilot is ready to contact the ground controller to their taxi clearance to the specific departure runway. Be sure to like our video and subscribe for more epic content. And while you're here, check out some of our more recent videos and playlists.